Okay.
Welcome to Girl in the Mirror Reflection, featuring my dear friend Willow.
Hi.
Say hi.
Hi there. Nice to meet you, Girl in the Mirror crowd.
Okay, let's move this camera a little closer.
Yeah. Oh, can I fix my tips?
Absolutely. Okay, so.
So.
I don't know, how long have you always lived here?
In Calgary?
Yeah.
I've lived in Calgary for about 18 years now.
Cool. And, like, what is your general opinion of Calgary?
My general opinion of Calgary is that people's intention is to come here, work, and then leave. And people are moving everywhere so quickly that they don't foster these, like, long-term or, like, enjoyable relationships because they feel like they're going to leave quickly. And so I feel like it's a really socially isolated city that's very hard to meet people in.
That's so interesting.
Thank you.
Would you credit that at all to the oil industry?
I would credit that almost entirely to the oil industry.
Okay.
So what are your thoughts on capitalism?
Capitalism. In my opinion, it is one of the most plaguing ideas that humanity has ever had. Fear that even still exists today.
What has that
about
same...
About socialism and about communism? And the thing is, I mean, when you... Sorry, there's a hairdryer going on.
Ow!
Also, I feel like it was really, during the Cold War, like, on, like, the political and economic spectrum, it's not, like, one line. It's actually, like, a cross.
And the goal of human life should be to be happy and to follow hedonism. And then we can look at the example of Denmark, which has the most satisfied citizens in the entire world.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, they are such a socialist, comfortably, almost bordering on libertarian in a way. And their citizens are so happy.
You know, during the first Obama election,
mm-hmm.
you know, they were calling him such a socialist.
And exactly.
They were exaggerating that fear, like...
Exactly, it was conflating socialism with
communist.
Communism.
Thank you very much, Willow.
You're welcome.
We're going to take a short break. Thanks for watching Reflections. Tune in after the break.
Look at my baby.
Hi, I'm Donna Matrix. So I guess the last vlog you saw...
No, wait.
All the other girls... Okay, come in here and do this.
Okay.
No, wait. Get in here. Safe.
Okay, are you decent?
Okay,
Okay,
for a second. Hi.
Hello, and welcome to the second segment of Reflections. And now it's time to introduce my dear friend and bandmate, Donna Matrix. Hi, welcome.
Hi.
Me, Willow, is going to be giving Donna Matrix a tattoo.
My first one! She's popping my cherry. Please be gentle.
It's going to be a tattoo much like the ones... that Jizzing and I have had.
Are you showing it
off?
The triangle.
Because we are a triad.
We're a triad. We are three, and we are a strong force to be reckoned with. Where do you want it, girl?
I'm right here.
Yeah.
Trying to move tonight.
Actually, funny story. If you don't like the clumpiness of mascara, use liquid liner.
For your mascara? I've tried to do it on my lashes, it doesn't work.
Really?
My lashes are really long, and it just messes it up. It gets,
really?
Like, fucked.
For me, it's
face.
The opposite.
Stay still.
I swear by liquid liner on my lashes.
I love liquid liner. Listen. Do my
Stay
bond. Okay.
Still.
Let's get bloody. Remember, tattooing people is a great way to pick up guys.
Oh, the guy you're sleeping with? Do you want to talk about that while you're doing this?
Is this the guy I met the other night?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll tell you what I know about him.
I do know him.
No, he's not much of a twisted guy. Where he does hang out is the house.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I recognized him because I used to go to open mic night there.
Mm-hmm.
And I used to sing a little bit. But he was always there, and he was always, like, the headliner there. He's really cute. Yeah.
Can I talk about, I just had a big bad breakup today. You guys might know Fez from a bunch of the other videos. He's been in, I think, 3. Unfortunately, to be honest, I'm learning a little bit more about myself, and I'm moving on to a different career. I think the kid is really good, and I think he'll do some very, very good things in his life, but unfortunately for me, I couldn't be on that same journey.
I want this angle to be more...
You need to be more in it, so...
I don't mean like the angle.
Carol, you know, it's like vintage chic.
Okay, let's finish this though, so crying. We all have to drive to go where we want to go, and we had the mission before, and everybody was on the same page, and it will still stay on the same page. Brooke, I learned so much just from being around you. You have such an eye for style, and I try to surround myself with people who think differently than me so I can see a new point of view on everything. And just being around you, and I think maybe I just always laugh every time you say anything because you think about things very differently than I do, and I love it. I love it, love it, love it. Because if you were surrounded by the same people who had the same ideals, then life sucks. And this isn't over.
It's not over.
And you know what? I'm an LGBT advocate. Okay. LGBTCA.
What's CA?
Lesbian, trans, bisexual, gay, or
gay, asexual.
Asexual. No, asexual ally and trans. What's confused? Or
the C.
The C. Yeah.
That's beautiful. Gotta say, actually, I've experienced so much support ever since I started drag from all of my peers. I've had people from high school message me being like, you know, I'm so proud of what you're doing and who you are and stuff. And I really appreciate that.
We'll be back. I need one. Actually, I need one now. I'm gonna cry.
We'll be back after these messages. We're just doing the finishing touches on Donna Matrix's tattoo. Well, I was down with Ivy Winters.
Yeah.
Now I'm down with Jinx Monsoon.
I think I'm a little bit down with Alaska. I know she's not going to win.
Okay, I love Alaska, but I'm sorry, but... I mean, how many times can you do the blacked out eye, the no hip pads with, like, a nude dress and, like, giant blonde hair? I'm sorry. No, she does, like...
Let's call a spade here, Brooke with an E.
Wears a nude dress...
I know.
No hip pads.
Yeah.
Well, you can. Yeah, and if she does, you can see the pads. And this 8 feet tall hair, and you know that is a look. That's a total look. I can get it. But I mean, it gets tiring. I think Jinx Monsoon has a lot more to offer.
I also do, but do you know what? Also, I know. I know some people in Seattle, and I know that she was Hedwig in the Angry Inch, while RuPaul's Drag Race premiere was. I know that she's doing a lot of work in Seattle, and she's just in Seattle right now.
Mm-hmm.
And I think if she won, she probably would have been quarantined.
It's okay. Even if she didn't win, I still think she's great.
So who's your favorite? Her?
Yeah.
Well done.
All right.
Oh, fuck
how's
me
it,
to
how's
Tuesday.
It look?
It looks good.
Coronation week. It's Coronation Week.
Yeah, Coronation Week. I still want to go.
You're going, girl. I have to do the business walk with Chi-Chi, and I'm really excited. I found, like, the perfect gown today. All right, let's do this lip sync.
Yeah, let's do a lip sync.
What do you want to do? We're never getting back together. You guys record. Okay, bye.
We hadn't seen each other in a month. you needed space. But then you come around again and say, baby, I miss you and I swear I'm gonna change. Trust me, remember how that lasted for a day? I say, I hate you, we break up, you call me, I love you.
Fuck you, Fez.
I want to do one.